Everybody, it's Victor. It's time to continue intrigue here in the Binding of Isaac Victor Afterbirth Plus series. Happy Monday, everyone, as we officially mark the end of Angel Deal Week, which I'm sure a lot of people probably are maybe excited about, I guess. I don't know. I'm kind of excited just because, I mean, it's been, let's be honest, pretty uneventful, but we'll talk about that in a moment. Here's your meme of the day brought to you by Bandit GD on the Sinvicta subreddit. Sinvicta going down to the next floor, 10 hours of silence. So for those of you who don't know why I do that, I've explained it before, but obviously, I mean, this job is all about repetition. The reason why I do that is because I don't know exactly how long an episode's going to be, and it allows me to have an ad break to insert there. Well, first off, see Days, Foxtrot Papa Alpha 7-6-4-8-3. Lots of numbers on there. Terrible damage, but we got Rotten Baby, good tears, good movement speed, good shot speed. Kind of a not great spacebar item, but of course the big thing we have to worry about right now is the fact that we just don't know how much HP we have. So I'm very happy that we were able to get out of a champion monstro, champion little monstro, I should say, room very quickly. But yeah, so just because I don't know how long an episode is going to be, obviously, since I record these live, I don't know where the ad breaks are going to be divided up into, and it gives me an opportunity to insert them in a way where it's not going to interrupt the flow of discussion or commentary. That way nobody misses it, and you feel like you know, for those of you who do take the steps to let the ads play out, you're not getting left behind in a conversation. I think that's the polite and courteous thing to do, but some people think it's silly, but you know, luckily I don't care what most people or some people really perceive all that as, because I mean, at the end of the day, it's just, yeah, it's just something, just a habit that I've gotten into. Scapular here. Scapular is going to give us a half soul heart if we take damage, or is it going to give us one soul heart or half soul heart? It's either a full or a half soul heart if we take lethal damage. It's good for one room and one room only, but you can refresh it by simply walking out and walking back into said room. It's very good for you can basically abuse the system in a little ways by, if you have like a arcade that has a blood bank in there, you can walk out, walk back in, and essentially have unlimited taps on the blood bank machine. Reason why I took that soul heart right now is because obviously we still don't know how much HP we have with it being Curse of the Unknown, and it's just a precautionary measure here. I walked out and walked back in that hallway because I wanted to realign myself so I don't use more than one bomb to get the free bomb, which it basically didn't cost us anything there, and we also get an extra penny. If I really wanted to, I could go to the store and maybe make something happen. We only have one key to really mess around with, but it's probably worth it, especially if we get something good. Get Squeezy was an excellent upgrade for us here to start off with, giving us another tiers upgrade, but more importantly, giving us two soul hearts so we don't have to worry about lethal damage coach. Okay, so I definitely want to use at least a bomb here to roll and also to get this nickel. Ventricle Razor showing up again. I feel like it hasn't been that long since we've seen that. Half price soul heart's pretty good, man. It's hard for me to pass that up. It really is. And I guess we'll take Butt Penny just to placate Butt Penny guy for now. Which, let's be clear, is a sentence I never ever want to say in my life ever again. So, ooh, now we get the Book of Secrets. Now I'm happy about that. As the stuttering has come back full circle here, I'm going to use our final bomb here just to get more money. It's a pretty good chance that we'll get one from from four keepers that we're dropping a bomb on. I almost said dropping a deuce on, and you don't want to be dropping a deuce on people. That's not proper in this day and age. And we'll finally toilet humor. Toilet humor is always going to be funny in some circles, especially in my circle. Head on down. We had a ton of HP. Book of Secrets is, of course, going to give us either the compass effect, the map effect, or the blue map effect randomly. And it can repeat effects, so just because you use it once and you get the treasure map effect does not mean that you're guaranteed to get a compass effect on the next turn. I think a lot of people honestly sleep on the Book of Secrets. It's not like a top-tier item, I would say, but it does give you... It gives you the combined effects of three different items. Just for using it, like you have a guaranteed shot to get one of three different very beneficial effects, and I think honestly it has more value than a lot of people really realize. And some people might say that, well, I'm putting too much value on the Book of Secrets, which I guess it could be technically true. I think it's a great item. I think it's just neat, as the Marge Simpson meme goes. A penny, by the way, does a Butterbean effect every time that we pick up a penny. All right, so we did not get ourselves a key, unfortunately, thanks to me buying that half-price soul heart. I still would do it every single time. But luckily, we got our Yave right here, and the Yave gives us something that takes Yaves, and I will not be giving away any more Yaves to that Yave vampire known as Ebum. We Ragman. So what are we looking for here? We're looking for damage. 2.83 damage is terrible. Even with Rotten Baby helping to support our damage, it's not enough to really be like, okay, we can start monologuing. You know, we're going to be able to just lay waste to everything in the room. No. No, we got ways to go here. I should mention really quickly yesterday's video going over 7,000 likes at the time of this recording. Very awesome indeed. We're back to getting that doubled, the double feature on the like streak goal. Thank you all very much for that. And I've got a fun like streak goal for the next one. People have been wondering, am I going to raise the like streak counter, like the actual goal itself, the number of likes. I don't know about that, because I feel like that's, at this point, I almost took that out of pure reflex. I almost took that. We don't really need red hearts, but at the same time, we don't really need butt penny. I'll stick with butt penny just for the meme, I guess. So yeah, so I almost completely accidentally took Horror Babylon as well as Abadabba Ding Dong. But what have we learned now that Angel Deal Week is coming officially to a close after this episode? We've learned that the game doesn't like giving you angel deals all that much. some people have been telling me, like, you know, I definitely could have done a little bit more to try to influence angel deals. Like, say, give ourselves, like, donate 10 cents per floor or something like that to give ourselves a better chance. Taking the key pieces, of course, was one of the easiest things that we could have done. But at the end of the day, still, it's up to RNG at that point, you know. And after a certain point, it's like, okay, well, I'm not gonna hold the game's hands trying to get something to happen if it's just not gonna spawn anyway. You know what I mean? Like, I don't really want to break the flow of the videos to take like extra couple of minutes just to be like, hey, you know what? I think this is worth doing. Let's donate a bunch of money to the keeper and just hope. You know, when in reality we could have used that on a later floor for something. It's all situational, is my point about that. And I wouldn't necessarily say that, like, it's worth pursuing an avenue that's just going to be temporary anyway. Like, we're not going to all of a sudden have some sort of epiphany and say, like, yeah, angel deals are just better than devil deals now. You know what I mean? But if anything, it shows this week that you can still be successful without having devil deals. I think that's probably the big takeaway from this past 7 days here, is that you don't technically really need devil deals to win, but my God, do they help out a lot. they really do. That's why I was talking about it on the stream this past weekend, where I was just saying, like, you know, it feels like a breath of fresh air to be able to take devil deals again. Yeah, Black Hole is not something that, I mean, Black Hole's okay, but to be honest, I'd rather have Book of Secrets. Well, Black Hole does deal a lot of damage, and also it can provide a makeshift block destroyer, should you need it. Careful now. Again, be careful with your autopiloting. Don't do what I just almost did. No reason to put yourself in that bad position. We get the actual treasure map, which would free me up to use. I'm actually going to leave that there. That would free me up to take and to get rid of the Book of Secrets and actually take Black Hole. But like, as soon as we get something better than Black Hole, I mean, technically, I think that the Book of Secrets is already better than Black Hole. Like I'm going to replace it. So, is taking the treasure map worth it right now? As opposed to say rolling for like say Black Candle or maybe Red Candle, like any of the candles to help out, help give us a little bit more of support firepower here in this run that we really are starting to be a little bit sketch about. Just due to the lack of damage. I think what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to use Black Hole against the big room. My computer can never like figure out how to load stuff. Then we can come back and get the Book of Secrets or stick with just Black Hole and get the treasure map. I would prefer to keep the Book of Secrets, but Black Hole, it gives us a more immediate advantage, I would say. Yeah, like, I don't know what's going on in here. Oh, it's Zubats. Okay, so we're going to wait for Zubats and the Flies, which is my favorite 1970s band. Yep. We will go back. You know what? Let's give Black Hole its due. It's not an item that you see me spend a whole lot of time with, and it can be useful against bosses. It's not a bad item. That's the thing. Like I'm gonna be critical of a lot of items, but that doesn't mean that they're bad and like they're just unusable. You know that's in the end of the at the end of the day, a lot of your opinions of these items are all subjective. To your own opinion. I mean, like, there's a lot of people who won't necessarily agree with my stance on a lot of items, and that's fine. Again, it's a hallmark of good game design of showing why Isaac is so evergreen, so infinite in possibilities, because there's so many different ways that you can take runs and opinions, and they're all right. You know, they're all right and they're all wrong at the same time. That's true good game design, and you don't really come across too many games, especially these days, that have that much discussion about them, because there's so many ways to interpret, you know, what's good, what's bad in the game. And Isaac does a phenomenal job at keeping itself relevant in those discussions. There's a penny somewhere. There it is. Oh, and two tarot cards. What in the world? I don't think I've ever seen. I may have seen this room, but I've never seen this. Okay, well, double strength card. Thank you, game. Glad that we used our last bomb for that. Got ourselves a charge key here and another key. I still would like to get the treasure map at least. If we're not going to go with the Book of Secrets, stick with Black Hole. Since I know now that we didn't get a damage upgrade here, unless we get some like miracle devil deal item. That shows up in this next room. Chances are we're probably not going to get a damage upgrade here, and Black Hole might actually now be better than taking the Book of Secrets. Even more so if we get a penny. I'm really just hoping that we get a penny and just call it a day. Need to be careful of the pink champions because they fire randomly, unpredictably. We got exactly one penny. It was meant to be. All right, so that makes me feel better. We'll go back and we'll get the treasure map. Say thank you to the Book of Secrets. I just had to try. I just wanted to do it out of my own curiosity, but I was not willing to use a bomb for that. It's great for crowd control. It's great for grouping stuff up and doing easy AoE damage to stuff. And good versus bosses, especially ones that spawn adds. So Black Hole, you know what? You're invited to the party. Let's go. Let's try to find out some more damage here, buddy. Okay, so we spawn basically in the middle of the map. And the problem is that we don't necessarily have anything to go off of. There's nothing that would lead me to believe that our item room isn't to the north first. You always have to be careful about that with where the item room spawns and whatnot, especially if you're just using the treasure map and nothing else to try to orient yourself in a location. Normally, this isn't true all the time, but normally your item rooms will spawn closer to where you've loaded into the zone than towards the end of it. Normally. But obviously that's not always the case. That's why I said normally. Yeah, so that would definitely not be the case here, because obviously it's not there. There's multiple champions. I actually am not okay with this room at all. This is where the weakness of Rotten Baby really shines, in the fact that you can't control where his shots are going. But you have to be real careful when you're surrounded by bomb flies. Two of hearts. That was absolutely a black hole room if we needed to use it. Fortunately, we didn't have a full charge for it, though, so what can you do? Look at this room again, which I am... Look, I'm all for this room, trust me, but if you give me this room and then give me nothing but greed fights afterwards, I'm not going to be happy. I'm not going to thank you for that, game. So this would be a good indication of what Black Hole can do against very strong champions. Suck them all in and you basically just mince them up. You make a fool out of themselves. I'm happy that we took chip damage there. Thank you, Rotten Baby. Rotten Baby is never a bad thing. You just have to be aware of... We really need damage. I'm going to take Chocolate Milk. I don't necessarily like Chocolate Milk anymore. But... excuse me. But you got to do what you got to do, right? I'm unsure if we're going to see any more damage upgrades here. And at least with us holding a full charge in our mouth ready to go, that's going to increase the overall damage that Rotten Baby does, because he will always fire. Even if we're not firing, Rotten Baby will still fire because we're holding down the fire button. So getting a little bit more exponential damage out of that, thanks to Chalk and Milk, is definitely worth it. And I'm very happy to see an orbital here. So give me that. Give me this death card. We can use that in the next room. We still have a full charge here for Black Hole against the boss. I'm actually going to use it here because Magic Mush would be incredible. Backing up away from the bad gas. The inevitable bad gas explosion there. Okay, let's see what we get. Hopefully out of this deal with the angels. Forsaken is in lots of trouble. I actually, for some reason, thought that it would pull him in there despite him being, like, grounded. I don't know why. Chocolate Milk, by the way, is an on-charge ability that will allow you to fire as fast as you want. Fire as fast or as slow as you want. So I think we have to take Seraphim here, because we just need the damage. And I'll begrudgingly do the Angel Statue. I say begrudgingly because, like, I don't think that, like, we're not going to use it, but if we can influence the Angel deal in any way, then I'll try. For our last day, I'll give it a Scout's try. Like, the good old college try. Keep a meat. But you're seeing here, this is what 3.03 damage looks like, even with Chocolate Milk. We need to get damage here. Like, we just... That's gotta happen. We got the key piece. Let's see if there's anything else that we could get in here. I could use another stack... I'm going to give myself one more damage up. The reason why I hesitate here... thank you, computer. The reason why I hesitate here is basically because I don't want to... I don't necessarily want level 3 Meat Boy. But at the same time, as you saw against Gabriel there, we really do need damage right now. It's only going to get harder from here on out if we don't get some kind of damage upgrade. Oh. I cannot believe that that shot went over that far. Okay, let's slow our roll here, because we're starting to take some pretty terrible damage. Excuse me. You two forget that there's a black hole in this room? I thought that maybe this would be the item room over here. Obviously, it was not. Apparently, that was also a full heart of damage. I was not expecting that. Now here, now this is a black room. If we had one room that just screamed, "This is where you use black hole," it'd be this room here. Because we really need to get into these. We need to crack some skulls. We need to get some good tarot cards. We need to get some runes. And yeah, somebody pointed out on Twitter, this is somewhat unrelated, but kind of related. It's Isaac related. Someone said, mentioned to me that Ed somewhere confirmed, I don't know what day it was on, apparently in Repentance, Blank Card will no longer use rune effects. And to me, that's just like, why? What? Like, so we really just aren't allowed to have fun in Isaac anymore. That's all I'm hearing. I'm gonna do the smart thing. I know it's a few and far between occurrence. I'm gonna do the smart thing and not take Steam Sale yet, because if there's Diplopia in the store, I want to be able to use that to our advantage. I'm not messing with you. It's a very odd occurrence there. You don't normally see mobs moving that quickly. Getting sucked in and then immediately like turning around. Right now, our top priority is getting to the store and hoping that there's a reroll machine in there, because we've got plenty of money. And we need to use it. Emperor card is huge for us, of course. I'm not going to get rid of the strength card, however, because we definitely are going to need it. Or something. Or what, I don't know, but the Emperor card makes me feel better about our current situation. Bobby Bomb is not going to cut it. Very thankful we have a reroll machine in here, however. Anyone's not going to happen. We need damage here, game. I will begrudgingly take movement speed. It gets us into the sweet spot in terms of our movement speed. Gives us range. It contributes to spawn, obviously. Is it the perfect upgrade or an upgrade that we really truly needed? No. A perfect upgrade there would have been Magic Mush. But it does at least alleviate some of the problems that we had on this run, which one of them being our lackluster movement speed. Okay, so we have Jar of Flies here, which I think we have to take Jar of Flies. Like this is a must take here. Unless if we end up seeing like a candle, which is it's possible. I'm gonna buy this bomb here, so it saves us a cheaper reroll next time we use it. Piggy bank I will take as well, but these are all these things that we're getting right now are not relevant. I will take the compass. Now we truly don't need the Book of Secrets. I will take PH Dizzle. Another Ace of Hearts, because of course. Really hoping that was going to doing that. I know what you're saying, Civicta. You forgot restock, you fool. Did I? So what I was really hoping that we were going to roll into... I'm glad that we rolled into restock, first off. But I was hoping that we would reroll into Diplopia so I would go back here and get Steam Sale. Did you think I forgot about Steam Sale? If I said do you think I forgot about restock, obviously I meant Steam Sale. I know it's confusing. But I was hoping that we were going to just see Diplopia there to get Steam Sale, and then with restock showing there, that's going to be like my exit point of the room, you know? I guess like I'll keep doing the strat until we come across either Diplopia or restock, and then we can really start getting into the meat and potatoes of it all. We'll happily take fate here, as we do need some flying. Wow. Mask of Infamy, which is not one of my favorite bosses. In fact, I think it's one of the more annoying bosses. It's also like the anti-fly boss of all time, other than maybe Carrion Queen. That part of Mask of Infamy is not difficult. This is the part that's difficult and also very annoying. I really like hate how fast Mask of Infamy can just decide to turn on you. Another Tears of Grey, which again is not going to help us at all. Thankfully, Piggy Bank was paying out with something. We should go into the curse room. And thanks to Fate, we're going to be able to reach that golden chest as well. I don't know why all the bombs just decided to show up there, but okay. The Counterfeit Penny doing some work for us here. And lucky us, we did not. We're not able to open up that golden chest, or the stone chest. I still want to do some more exploring here. Is that these bombs can open up the stone chest here? Could try to bomb one of those keepers for a nickel, but I'm not going to. An Eternal Heart, awesome. That's one thing I was hung up about, was possibly losing this Eternal Heart. But again, since we have restock, we have purchasing power now. And what would be great is if we found a half price soul heart now that we have restock enabled. Lots of full charges in here that's potentially good use for something. Arma, I think that Capri Penny is still going to be more useful here. Oh yeah, we have PhD as well. Okay, well, at least PhD was doing its job. I'm hoping that Repentance adds some new pill effects. I think that it's already been confirmed that there will be new pill effects, but man. I'm just ready to get useful things back in Isaac. You know, give me pills that matter. They don't necessarily all have to be good. In fact, I don't want them to be good. You have to have bad if you're going to have good. Otherwise, the good isn't good. It's just the norm, right? But like, honestly, who can say that having a pill like Retrovision is a good idea or a good thing for the game? I don't think anyone really can. My whole point is that, like, I'd rather see them put work and effort into making items that matter for the run-of-the-mill usual runs than, like, adding another pill that just does nothing again. You know, there's plenty of ways and plenty of items in the game that just do nothing. So I'm hoping that as Repentance keeps getting pushed further and further away, that more refinement's happening item-wise. Yeah, the good items wouldn't be super duper good if, like, brimstone wouldn't be brimstone if there wasn't, like, you know, the chance of you getting the shovel or something in a devil deal, or a cursed eye in the devil deal. You know, you have to have bad orbitals for the good ones to really stand out. Like, I get all, like, I understand the concept there. The problem that I have is just that, yeah, there's just too much of that happening. There's too many neutral, there's too many negative, there's too many bad items and pill effects and cards and everything in the game. When it could be something more, much more interesting and entertaining, I think. Like, you if you look at one that makes you larger, it does nothing. It does absolutely nothing for your character. It just makes you bigger, that's it. And that's not an advantage, necessarily. In fact, you can get it to the point where you're so big, it obscures the screen and makes the game virtually impossible to play. You know, I would rather see that turned into something else, like a sack head, or maybe like a pill effect that has a chance to either randomly increase a stat or decrease a stat. And I don't mean like speed up, speed down, we already have that in the game. I mean like a pill that's like an experimental pill that says it's going to either increase one stat or it's going to lower one stat. It's called the experimental pill or something. Anything like that. We could go hard here for a tarot cloth, or for a tarot card, but I don't see any point of doing that. I also don't want to really do any fishing for premium items right now when we can find a half-price one. That was a... I did not mean that. Oh, but... Hang on a second. We did get a temperance machine now. I'm going to take Nun's Habit because it's always a good idea. The battery I will take begrudgingly. Speaking of pill effects. Got a second Emperor card. Okay, we need to roll until we have red hearts. Okay, there's our half price premium item. That's what we're looking for here. Starter deck. Excellent. Boomerang, whatever. Okay. So now we are at the point where... Thanks to the counterfeit penny, and thanks to restock, we are able to create more money than we spend. So, that means that we've won the game. Essentially, this means that we have won the game. Because with chaos and with restock, it's a done deal here. Good. Good. I'm glad that we get to have a nice, just a leisurely run here. And also, this means that we can go get some payback on Lamb for my own mistake, which I'll just blame on the game, because of course, me as the important YouTuber, I'm blameless. I can never do any wrong. I mean, I guess we could just sit on it. We can just sit on this node until we get chaos. Mom's purse. Play in a box. Cool bag, whatever. 9 volt. Oh, razor. Mom's key. Brack Kindadu. With nickel. Champion belt. Now we're talking. Ventricle razor. I'd consider re-rolling this run. I did use the trinket smelter just because. I'm a mega. Blank card. Bibble. Okay, go. Car battery. Little baggy kind of ruins blank cards day, but what can you do? Nose Goblin is excellent. So I will use the Trinket Smelter along with the IV bag to smelt Nose Goblin. We picked up Chaos now, so we know that... We know that missing no is possible. We can still take... Oh, we got a Hero Fund card. We can still take blank card Emperor and catch up to where we need to go as far as the time is concerned. Glitter bombs can also, of course, break the game. Oh, wow. We get Prism. How do you ruin my day? That's how. Now, at the... In the interest of keeping things interesting, which is a very, very odd thing to say, I'm going to leave Isaac's heart there, and I'm willing to take blood rites if it shows up. just so we can have a very rare. I mean, I'm sure that you, judging by the thumbnail, maybe, maybe not. You will know the answer to this. Balance. Gonna be spun here. On mushroom, kidney bean. Guess this chain, which I'm not a huge fan of. Keep doing that. Ace of hearts. I want to make sure that we're holding onto the Emperor card before anything else. Doors box. Chaos card.
The High Priestess.
Emperor's Machine. The High Priestess card. There's our Emperor card. Okay. I'm gonna take the Emperor card and drop it out. Can we drop it out here? Did we get starter deck before or after Little Baggy? I want to say after. I guess we'll find out. Okay. So the reason why I did that is because I'm just trying to get some of the cards like out of here. Off the ground. So I know that obviously that's going to take up the coins that we made, but look, we've got unlimited money here. Okay. Box of spiders, sack of sacks. If Blood Rite shows up, I will take it, and I will take Isaac's heart. That's the deal here. Ooh. That is this Black Rune. Black Rune's got me excited. Let's use Pandora's box first because we're missing out on an item if I don't. Or maybe not. Maybe I don't know what I'm talking about. Make sure we don't void IV bag. Here we go.
Black Rune.
All right, Infestation 2. Just to clean things up a little bit in here. And also, of course, gives us massive stats. We essentially have unlimited stats now, thanks to Black Rune. Bookworm. I'm gonna take it just because I don't feel like messing with chocolate milk anymore. But if we end up using Blood Rites, then I don't even have to worry about using Mom's Knife. I'm going to actively look for Blood Rites here. No. But if we don't get it, I'm not taking Isaac's heart. I get crazy now. That's going to be the box. And not tell what that is, thanks to Fate's Reward, so. Yeah, I still can't tell what that is, Fate's Reward. Just want to move over here. Thank you. Penny, Mushroom's Lung, what we had yesterday. That bomb's good. Got a luck upgrade there. I agreed. Lives. I can get the item already. Okay, so because I got rid of all of our red hearts, I'm not able... This is what I'm going to do. I'm going to fish for the Two of Diamonds. That way, I don't have to do any shenaniganery, tomfoolery with the hearts anymore. What is dropping bombs on us?
Black Rune.
Need to put down the IV bag real quick so I can swap to... I want to get blank card lined up with the Hierophant. There we go.
The Hierophant. The Hierophant. The Hierophant.
We're essentially doing what I was doing, except we've inversed it now to where we're not using Red Hearts as our economy, but we're using Soul Hearts. Okay, let's fish real hard for... the two of diamonds. Gonna stand over here because there's nothing, no reason not to. So we're gonna leave with the Emperor card and the blank card, obviously. This just sort of speeds up the whole process here. One of the only times you'll hear me get disappointed that we re-rolled Isaac's heart. I was actually looking forward to doing that. I mean, it's possible that Isaac's heart might show up again, but... Hearts, two of clubs. All right, we've seen all the twos except for the one we want game. Yeah, we've already seen that one. Got a dice shard, oh boy. Yeah. Yeah, let's do that. Get our HP back up, and then we'll swap out the dice shard for the Hierophant. And let's suck up everything. No, that's not what we want. There we go. All right, continuing. Look, this can be real easy on you, game. All you gotta do is give us the two of diamonds. All you gotta do is give us the two of diamonds. That's all we're looking for. It's that simple. Like, we're going to get the two of diamonds here, game. This is something that's going to happen. So however long it takes us to get there is up to you. But this is happening. You not one credit card. Game. Please. You're gonna make me do this again. You're gonna make me get the Hierophant card.
The Hierophant.
Okay. Just keep it going, I guess.
Victor, you don't have to do this.
Well, no, I do. At this point, I'm determined. The gauntlet has been thrown down. We'll not let the game get one over on us. We'll swap that for that. We'll swap that for that for that. That for that. We're going to get a full charge here and clean up the floor real quick. Then we'll do it again. Hearts. Chariot. Hangman. Lover's card. Tower card. Wheel of Fortune. Fool card. Death card. Ace of Diamonds. I'm pretty sure we've seen every card now at this point, other than the Two of Diamonds. I know what you're thinking, game. You're thinking that you're going to get away with this, but you're not. All you're doing is you're just wasting my time and all these fine members of the Mosh Pit's time. I mean, what kind of jerk are you? Somebody should count. Somebody count how many cards we've gone through so far.
Two of spades.
Because I'd love to know. Okay, so we need to get more. Need to excuse me a minute while I just create more money. Go. All right, so we need to swap the Hero Font card with that one here, like that. There we go. There we go. Back to 99 cents we go. I'm going to swap, put this down. That, swap that. Nope. There we go. Black rune it up. And keep on going. All right. Here we go. Judgment. World card. Two of hearts again. World card. Temperance. Ace of clubs. Hangman. Magician. Ace of hearts again. Temperance. Emperor. Rules card. Chubb doesn't like smoke. Justice. Magician. Two of hearts. Moon card. Judgment card. High Priestess, Devil card, World card, Lover's card, Magician, Question Mark card, Tower card, Devil card, Fool card, High Priestess card, Emperor card, Sun card, Fool card, and Ace of Hearts. Fantastic. Go ahead and feel free to skip over. Just you can just mouse over the entire, scrub through this entire section. I am not leaving this room until we have a two of diamonds. That is a Sinvicta guarantee.
Just give it up, Sinvicta God.
Excuse me. Who do you think you're talking to? We don't give up here. If I tell the game is going to do something, it's going to do it. Again, how long it takes us to get there is entirely up to the game. Pop that. Nope. Yep. You need to buy another full charge, however. Black. Continuing. Wheel of Fortune. Two of spades. Levers, World card, Hierophant card. I realized that I could have been going through like all the items at this point, but now I'm just determined.
Little Zeno, we patched out two of diamonds, so it doesn't work with blank card anymore. He's so cool. Not as cool as Ragman though. He's the coolest. So cool.
All right. Here we go. Let's put this down for a second. Put this down for a second. Put this down for a second. I don't really need the Hero Font card anymore, so I'm just going to do that to clean that up. And then we need to put the two of diamonds down real quick. Swap it. Get it back. Swap it. Get that back. Here we go. Finally ready to go. Diamonds. Coach. Okay, Guppy's Collar gives us Guppy, HP, Lance, Mom's Bra, Halo of Flies, Halo itself, Demon Baby, I'm not crazy about, Dad's Key, Iroh, Mr. Boom, or I should say just Boom, not Mr. Boom. Oh, Mr. Boom, that's my name, that name again is Mr. Boom. Back in just so I can see what's going on here. Blue candle. Remember the time when we came back here and we thought that we were going to need blue candle? Man, those are the days. For Mega. Hourglass, which is something we don't need. Natural from below. What are we looking for here? I don't know. At this point, we're just looking for something fun, something neat. Cammy's head is definitely neat. Rune bag. Getting all the bomb upgrades out of the way. Close of O, I'm less thrilled about, but we got to go through it. Dark Matter, of course. It would be nice if we had a half-price premium item.
Two of diamonds.
Did I buy the battery? Yeah. So I'll take that. Let me. Hang on a second there. Okay. First, the tower is where I draw the line. Let's see if we can get a half price premium item. Grab his tail. There's Diplopia. Yeah, mushroom. We actually didn't need that at all, but anyway. There's tarot cloth. Bob's brain. Sure, why not? First eye is also where I draw the line here. And C, rosary, hairball. We have void, Zach altar, which we will use right now. Get dunce cap. Sure, why not? The only thing I know I don't want is void. I do not, or not void, but the cursed eye. Swap that. Turn that. There we go. Swap that. Take that. I'm going to use Diplopia real quick just to create more item pedestals. And then we black rune everything. Continuing. Take that. Swap that. Put that down. Swap that. Get that. There we go. Okay. I'm going to roll past Cursed Eye because I don't accidentally want to pick it up. Let's curse the tower again. Little Steven. I'd say it's always great to see you, but we all know that that's not a lot. That's just a bold-faced lie right there. Book of Shadows. Yeah, and toothpicks. I will stop when we get, like, something like the, I don't know. Or I'll stop whenever we get Cursed Eye for the 10th time. Okay. Two of diamonds. All right. I'm just going to use a black rune there. There we go. Emperor card. We are golden. Let's go. Took us a while to get there, but we got there. Mr. Dolly. I mean, forget me now. Forget me now is definitely interesting. That was definitely one of our longer breaks, I would say. But I'd say it's worth it. Again, it's nice to have a nice just calm, easygoing run to end Angel Deal week on a non-Angel Deal Angel Deal. And we will definitely do a victory lap to compensate for the goof-up the day before yesterday with the negative and Cathedral. Somebody asked in the comments last week, or not last week, well, last night, I should say, asking me about, you know, do you consider runs, like, is it a strategy to go to mom and then take, like, say, the Polaroid and then go to Shoal instead of going to, oh my god. I don't know what happened to Uriel there, but would you consider it a strategy taking the Polaroid and going to Shoal? And then, and, you know, that way it ends the run a little bit sooner. And I told the person, I said, it's a strategy, sure. It definitely is a strategy, but I wouldn't. There are many people in the Isaac community, including myself, who would kind of see that as like a cop out. A run really isn't a run in the classical sense, unless if it goes to either Blue Baby or the Lamb in Afterbirth Plus. I just realized I took the Polaroid. Is there a sacrifice room? There's not. I didn't even think about that. See? Again, going to autopilot. There's a sacrifice room. We can still get to the Lamb. No sacrifice room. Well, at least we know that we can get Mega Stand. It's actually probably better that we're not doing the Lamb because this run's already, this video's already 54 minutes and 44 seconds long. It's like a Shovel Knight, baby. No sacrifice room here. Let's go fight Blue Baby real quick, just to see what we got going on. And we'll work our way backwards. See if we get a Delirium Portal here. Did not. So our damage is fairly good right now. At AWAS. So yeah, so in other words, I would never go into a run and have a run be so bad where I'm like, okay, for once we're going to use this cheesy strat, right? I would never say like, okay, like we just got to get out. Like we got to get an exit strategy. This is more like preserving the streak is more important than honor at this point. And deliberately take the Polaroid but go down to Shoal. I think there'd be a lot of people who'd be upset with that. And honestly, I'd be upset at myself as well for doing that. So if you want to call it a strategy, you can. Just know that it's usually not looked highly upon amongst the Isaac community. Of course, I don't speak for the entire community. The Isaac community is awesome. It was one of the tangents I meant to go on today. Which I may save for tomorrow. If we go down the void, I'll go on that tangent. If not, then I'll save it for tomorrow's episode. But I've got nothing but nice things to say about the Isaac community. I did something that I never ever usually do. But I looked for mentions of myself. Hey, there we go. I get to tell the story now. Yay. So essentially, I Googled myself, but on Reddit, specifically talking about the Binding of Isaac subreddit, because I'm always curious. I think it's important to get like a little bit of the pulse of the community to see what you could be doing better or what you've done wrong, etc. And in almost every instance, not all of them, but almost every instance, someone at least had something nice to say about me or the streak or the video or the channels, and that really. To me, that really like stood out amongst the usual run of the mill what you would expect from a public forum like Reddit, which of course I have nothing bad to say about Reddit because I've always enjoyed Reddit, but it just it made me feel real good and really honored that a community so involved and so big as the Isaac community. Mostly feels pretty positive towards the streak and the channel and myself as a personality. I don't know what I was expecting going in there. I wanted to see if people had anything critical to say or stuff that I could improve. So basically, just looking for stuff I could improve. And I never ever like query myself in doing that. This is the first time I've ever done that, anything like that. And I'm not going to make a habit out of it. But it was interesting just to have a completely arbitrary random idea like that turn out to be so positive. And I was like, man, that like it made me feel good. It really did. And to see I saw lots of posts from like channels who were inspired by my channel. People were saying that they want to start their own streaking channel and whatnot. And that kind of stuff it brings into perspective how far my channel has grown over the year. Basically over the year. That's not a misspeak. I mean, the channel has been going crazy this past year. I have a feeling that's delirium down to the bottom left. And it just made me feel good. It made me feel really appreciated, I guess. And it's so easy... It's so easy to lose sight of that with the way that new media goes. So, thank you to the Isaac community for the kind words. I don't think that I contribute much, really, if at all, but a lot of people feel that I do. They say that the majority of the people said that it's mostly because they learn a lot from these videos. And I try my best to teach. I mean, again, I don't profess to be the greatest Isaac player in the world. Many of my friends are much better at the game. And I'll always readily and happily say that about my friends. Again, it's something that I talked about very recently. If I had to put money on a run and say, okay, you have one person in the entire world. It doesn't have to be a friend, even though he is a friend. what that you would put money on to say we need to win? Like, say aliens come down and say we're gonna destroy your planet if you don't win this game. You have to guarantee a one run. Who is your champion? I would say Cobalt. Put in Cobalt. Oh, actually, Delirium's over here. Cobalt, in my opinion, is the best Isaac player out there right now. And probably ever. He plays more than anyone else that I know, including myself. I don't play Isaac that much. Nowhere near as him. And I in no way wish to be compared to Cobalt's, because it's not even close. Cobalt is just a better player. And we had a discussion about this very recently. And I told him, I was like, yeah, dude, you're like, I consider you the master. If there was ever a master of Isaac, it would be you. And I mean it. I feel that Ryan is a better player. His mechanics are better than mine. I feel that Frag is a better player than I am. The only thing for me is that I found a safe way to reliably win at the Binding of Isaac. He took it. Oh my God, we got ourselves a thumbnail, boys. Yeah. I wanted to say that because too many people get hung up on, oh, so and so's better. Oh, you know, so this person's better, that person's better. And I'm happy that I can contribute, that people feel that I can contribute and do contribute to the Isaac community in a way when I feel like I haven't really done anything to deserve that kind of praise. And to see that, to do that search and just kind of take a peek on what the pulse of the Isaac community is and how they feel towards the mosh pit and whatever, and getting the results of that, that really did make my day. And even if it was full of negativity and people are like, oh, I can't stand him, or oh, I hate his voices, or he's just so, you know, whatever, they just don't like me. You can always learn from criticism like that to say, okay, well, some people just aren't going to like you, and that's fine. Who cares about them? But the people who actually like, you know, well, complains too much, or oh, he plays too safe. It's like, okay, well, you know, that kind of stuff we can work on. You know, I just thought it was a neat interaction that I got from doing that, and really good insight. But trust me when I say I wholeheartedly, 100% believe and will stick by the claim that I am not the best Isaac player in the world, nor do I want to be. I'll let someone else have that title. Thank you for watching, everyone, sincerely. I really do appreciate it. Let me know in the comments down below what you thought about this run. Would you have broken the run like we did? Would you have been that patient to break the shop like that? Take 30 minutes out of a day just to do that, just for an easy win? I know I would have, because it's a lot of fun to do, and I know a lot of people like to watch it. Hope you had a great start to your day, everyone. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.